Ninth one, let's do ninth one.
Okay, sir. Uncle G. T.
Did I say B, right?
No, sir. One second.
Others also, please type in your response if you don't want to speak up.
So just a sec.
One second, sir.
I'm gonna say
A. But before I say anything, I won't say anything.
Now keep your options ready with you.
One second, sir. Before one second, please. T F. Yeah, I guess I'll say B. But I need more time, which is sad. So I'm redoing it, sir. One second. I messed up somewhere.
Niyati, what about the this one, present one? Have you done this present one?
Do you want to get the almost done? Equivalent to... Sir, I'm saying A, sir.
Yeah, I'll say A. Yeah, I was insane for saying B. Yeah,
I'll say A, sir.
Yeah.
Can we discuss quickly? Yeah. So this will be P.
Yes, sir.
See, this is false. So true.
F.
False. Correct. So true will be
T.
True. False will be true. This will be also
False.
Negation will be true. False.
Mirror image. Yeah.
Same as true. False.
False. True.
So this is equivalent to A.
Yes, sir.
Ideally, I should have made all of them, but you know, first option, I just tried it out and it was matching. A is the correct option.
So, tautology fallacy, pakka, you can remove them. I mean, yeah. Because there's only one thing, right? So, one time it will be a false. Better not take the risk, but sure.
Last one. Negation of this guy is equivalent to.
So, I'm pretty sure no one liked the sophists. That's why they were wondering. Okay. Yes.
Okay, Vidyuta, note it down your answer. Vidyuta has already answered.
I just finished writing the titles of the truth table.
Few things you can directly apply. You can apply that, what do you call?
Murgan's law.
S and negation of this. Negation of this will be R.
Oh, R that dash S, yeah.
This is like your, distributive property. So think as if it is S. Intersection R union S complement. S intersection R union S intersection S complement. But this is the null set.
Universe. Null set.
Answer will be this. So you don't have to actually bother doing it. Option D is right. Thanks to the property of sets that we can use there. See, the choice of this symbol was also because it was resembling your union and intersection. This is like your intersection. This resembles like that. This is like your union.
Yeah.
Okay. So guys, last part is left. We'll complete that and we'll do more questions. Don't worry, after we have completed this, we'll take up more questions. The last part of this topic is validation of statements. Validating statements. This is important from your school point of view, but it will not be asked in JEE actually, because this is proving it by writing a set of statements and sentences, which definitely will not be required in JEE. Okay. Now, here we'll be learning how to validate two types of statement. One is your if-then implication, and the second one is your if and only if statement. What is the meaning of validation or validating? Proving it is true. Okay. So first, let us start with if then. So if you have been given any statement, which is an if then implication, that is if P then Q, then we normally have three ways to prove it. Okay. The first method is what we call as the direct method. In this method, what we do, we follow these two steps. We first assume that P is true. Okay. And then by assumption in the first, we prove that Q is true. So if my both P and Q become true, we know that if P then Q has to be true. So it works on this particular truth table. Let me give an example. Let me give an example on this. Let's say, let me pull out a good example for this. If N is an even number, then n square is an even number. Or you can say even integer. Okay. Now let us say we want to use our direct method to validate this if-then statement. So when you're doing it in school, always first mention what are you calling as P and what are you calling as Q. What is P here? P is basically n is a
n is an even number.
Even integer. Okay? You can write integer.
Integer, yeah.
Okay, is an even integer. And what is your consequent? N square is an even integer. Okay, keep it as simple as possible. Do fancy stuff while writing statement. Now, by direct method, we'll first say let P be true. That is, you're saying N is an even number. N is an even integer. So let N be 2, let's say m. Okay. Now, what is n square? N square can be written as 4m square. This is a can you mute your mic? Yeah. So now you can write this as 2k, where you are calling k as your 2m square, which definitely implies that n square is even. That means you have proved that Q is true. So by assuming P is true, if you have been able to prove that Q is true, that means it implies this is also true by this truth table. Okay. Now many people ask, what if P was actually not a true statement? Now let us say it was false also, but if you prove that your consequent is true, then still false true will give you a true. Remember, did not get a promotion, still took his wife for the Singapore trip. That's still a true statement. Okay. So here, assumption itself being false doesn't matter to us. Are you getting my point? So this implies this is true. That means this statement here is a true statement. Understood how direct method works? Now, the next method, which is B. So A, we have already discussed direct method. So I'll go up. another method which we call as the contrapositive method. Contrapositive method. What are the steps that we follow for contrapositive method? In contrapositive method, okay, step number one, let Q be false. That is, you are saying negation Q be true. Okay? And using this assumption, okay, by your first assumption, if you prove that P is false, that is, you are able to prove that negation P is true, then basically what you have done something which you did in the direct method, but now applied to negation P and negation Q. So that means this is true. And since this is logically equivalent to this, it means this is also true. Hands done. Now you must be wondering.
1 second, sir. Yes. Let Q be false by one P is false. Okay.
Prove that by using one, prove that by using the first assumption, prove that P is false. That means your negation P is true.
Yes, sir.
That means you are proving that if not Q, then not P. This is actually the positive of this. And both we have seen from the truth tables that these two statements are logically equivalent to each other.
Yes, sir.
Therefore, if this is true, this guy also has to be true because they follow the same truth tables. Correct?
Yeah.
Now, where do we need a contrapositive approach? Let me go back and give you the same question in a slightly different way. Let's say there's a statement R which says, if n square is an even number, even integer, then n is also even. Okay. Now try to prove this by using direct method. If you use direct method, you'll see that there are some bottlenecks. For example, let n square be even. You can say let's say this is your P and let's say this is your Q. So let P be true. If you say that, you are then saying n square is equal to even number. So let's say it's 2m. Then your n is under root 2m. Now we are clueless whether how do we show that this is also even. So direct method fails. It is not a convincing way of doing it. Because you will not be able to convince the examiner that if 2m under root is also a even number. This is a direct rule, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So this has a, you can say, shortcoming. So we cannot use direct method. So let us use contrapositive method. So in contrapositive method, what we'll say, let Q be false.
Okay.
That is, you are saying n is not an even number.
But n squared is even.
Okay. Wait. So let n be odd. By the law of excluded middle, if something is not even, it has to be odd. Correct? So let n be 2m plus 1. Correct? So n square will be 2m plus 1 square. That's nothing but 4m square plus 4m plus 1. That's nothing but twice of 2m square plus 2m plus 1. It is called as 2k plus 1. That means it is odd. Correct?
Yes, sir.
What have you proved that n square is odd?
Dash n.
Which implies you have proved that it's false. Correct? That is, you have proved that negation P is true. Correct? So by making an assumption that negation Q is true, you have proved that negation
Q.
So we can say that this is true and hence This is true because both are equivalency. Are you getting my point? How it works?
Yes, sir.
Okay.